Ascent Audio, a division of Recorded Books, presents The Creative Contrarian, 20 Wise Fool Strategies to Boost Creativity and Curb Groupthink, by Roger Von Eck, narrated by Barry Abrams. Publisher's note, in this audio edition, you will hear references to visual materials present in the print and ebook formats of the book. Introduction. If anyone among you thinks he is wise in this age, let him become a fool that he may become wise. St. Paul, 1 Corinthians, chapter 3, verse 18. Discovery consists in looking at the same thing as everyone else and thinking something different. Albert Szentgyörgyi, Hungarian biochemist. I've been a lifelong student of the creative process. From my college days on through to my professional career as an author, business consultant, speaker, conference producer, product developer, and more recently as a toy designer, I've been interested in how and when the mind does its best work. When does my mind feel most alive? Truth be told, it's when I allow myself to take on the role of the wise fool. Indeed, I've had an enduring fascination with this character. His free-spirited energy, his unexpected observations, and most importantly, his ability to shake people out of their habitual responses to problems so that they might conjure up more imaginative solutions. The wise fool is an archetypal figure, such as the sage, the magician, and the healer, who resides deep within the human psyche and fulfills a purposeful role in society. The wise fool is the one who looks at life in different and often non-traditional ways and pushes back against the status quo. We might recognize this character today as the creative contrarian. Historically, wise fools were hired by the powerful, kings, emperors, pharaohs, to be a kind of thought pattern disruptor. Their job was to take a whack at the assumptions that kept their clients mired in conventional thinking. They did this so the rulers might see the issues before them in a fresh light. When I don my wise fool's cap, I feel like I am in my best thinking self. This means that I am a little less dogmatic and a lot more playful. Less afraid to be the guy who asks the stupid questions and more skeptical of received truths. Less convinced that I've got the right answer and more likely to see the humor in ambiguous situations. I'm also more amused at the unexpected and unintended things that come my way. Decades ago, right after I completed my doctoral studies, I interviewed for a job with IBM, still the world's greatest company back then. To prepare myself, I read a history of IBM, and one particular passage jumped out at me. At a board meeting in the early 1960s, IBM chairman Tom Watson Jr. was discussing the company's culture, and he lamented that far too many IBMers thought alike, dressed alike, and behaved alike. "What we need here," he said, "are a few wild ducks." At my interview, I quoted this story, which delighted my interviewers, and told them that I wanted to be one of those wild ducks Watson desired. I got the job, but I soon realized that it's okay to be a wild duck just as long as you fly in formation. From this, I learned that thinking in a different, contrary fashion wasn't always welcome. Fortunately, I listened to my inner wise fool and decided to pivot. This experience showed me that there was a need for people to use their creative abilities and consider alternatives. Not all of the time, obviously, but even just 5% of the day would be a real boon both to themselves and to their organizations. I filled this need by starting a company to help people develop their own creative thinking skills, which I brought to many organizations around the world. During my many years of conducting creativity seminars in business, I discovered that those exercises I did that involved wise fool thinking were usually my clients' favorites. That's because they yielded a lot of provocative ideas pertaining to their respective companies. The participants found that being a creative contrarian can be fun. Quick quiz. The term wise fool thinking may be foreign to some, but its underlying specifics are recognizable and practiced by many. For example, have you ever felt like you were in a room full of crazy people all thinking the exact same thing, and then mustered up the courage to offer a contrary viewpoint? Laughed at one of your most beloved ideas to test its validity? Felt dissatisfied with the first right answer you found and then looked for some ambiguity in the problem to give yourself room to think? Behaved counterintuitively to accomplish an objective, say, gone to the city to be alone? If so, you're familiar with wise fool thinking. Important distinction. There are two types of fools, the young fool and the wise fool, the subject of this work. The former often does stupid stuff, messes things up, and has neither the skills nor the understanding to know any better. The wise fool, on the other hand, does things by design. His objective is to challenge and provoke people's thinking into unfamiliar territory. As I reflect on my life, I would say that having a measure of wise fool savvy has been an asset in my mental portfolio of skills, abilities, and beliefs. I'm not alone. Over the years, I have talked with successful people in various walks of life, and many of them have expressed a similar gratitude for having a bit of the wise fool in their outlook, especially when it was necessary to think differently and then act contrary to the crowd to produce innovative ideas. I believe that most people could benefit from having some wise fool know-how in their approach to the world. Unfortunately, there hasn't been a simple guidebook laying out the elements of wise fool thinking, sort of like what Machiavelli did for the ruthless management of power in The Prince, or what Aristotle did for the essentials of dramatic theory in his Poetics. That is, until now, I present to you The Creative Contrarian, 20 Wise Fool Strategies to Boost Creativity and Curb Groupthink. This work provides you with the basics in how wise fools approach life, problem-solving, decision-making, and of course, letting their voice be heard. In it, we will examine the 20 essential ideas that give wise fools their wisdom. These powerful strategies will allow you to incorporate their cognitive orientation into your mental processes so that you too can do your own best work. Why did I write it? A quick story. A few years after starting my own company, I found myself in the office of Steve Jobs, then Apple's chairman. He was in his mid-20s. This was during his first stint at the company. We were talking about the ideas he would be presenting at an upcoming conference I was producing dealing with high-tech innovation. I asked him, "Why did you start Apple?" His answer has stayed with me ever since. "We make what we want for ourselves. I always wanted a personal computer, but there wasn't one available, so I had to put myself in a position to create one." Similarly, I've long been infatuated with wise fools, and I wanted to create a guidebook that boiled their wisdom and strategies for being a creative contrarian into an easily accessible form. I also wanted to include some of my favorite stories in it, both from long ago and recent ones as well. This is the sort of resource I wish had been available to me at various times in my own life. Say, when I needed to think things over and unlearn an idea or two, especially when I was making major life decisions. This also would have been a boost when I was planning projects, and certainly when I was in school, to counteract some of the dogmas that were being dished out. This work is a modest tip of the cap to the ancient Greek philosopher Socrates, history's most extraordinary wise fool. Socrates had, as you may recall, his own personal daemon, a kind of internal oracular spirit to whom he could turn when he needed some guidance and inspiration. I contend that each of us has something similar nestled within our lobes, an inner creative contrarian with whom we can consult when we need to think differently or buck the crowd. Sometimes wise fools may say, kiss a favorite idea goodbye, or seek other right answers. At others, they may advocate, flex your risk muscle, or exercise humility. Whatever their counsel, it's prudent to give it consideration. Simply put, you may think of this book as a stimulant to help you gain a different perspective and an antidote to conformity and groupthink. You can listen to it all in one sitting, if you wish. In putting it together, however, my primary design criterion has been to create a resource that you can dip into anywhere on a regular basis whenever you need a bit of inspiration from the wise fool to think differently. Some of you may be familiar with my products, perhaps one of my books, for example, a whack on the side of the head, whose Don't Be Foolish chapter provided the seeds for this current work, or my creativity tools, such as the Creative Whack Pack card deck and app, and the Ball of Wax line of design toys. If so, you are already aware of my fondness for the wise fool's contrarian behavior. You may also recognize a few of the anecdotes I've used to bring the wise fool to life. I trust these perennial ideas will continue to light up your mind and inspire your own wise fool. You might be interested to know that I have been collecting wise fools of various sorts for over 4 decades. Sculptures in wood, steel, bronze, ceramic, drawings, etchings, posters, needlepoint, cups, jewelry, and masks. If you were to visit my studio, you would see wise fools just about everywhere. I hope you'll find the creative contrarian to be of value both when you need another point of view and also when you're in groupthink situations and need to push back. I trust you will enjoy working and playing with the concepts in this book. Stay curious and be imaginative. Roger Von Eck, Woodside, California. Part 1. Meet the Wise Fool. Jesters do oft prove prophets. William Shakespeare, English playwright. 1. What does the wise fool do? Let's suppose that you're dealing with a challenging issue and it resists your best efforts. You feel like you are doing everything right, but things just aren't flowing. Perhaps your imagination is off, or your powers of discernment aren't focused. You've tried various techniques to jumpstart your creative process, but you still feel stuck. You think to yourself, who can give me a different perspective? One answer is to do what problem solvers and decision makers since the dawn of civilization have done to stimulate their imaginations and improve their judgment. Ask a wise fool what he thinks. Wise fools were consulted by Egyptian pharaohs and Babylonian kings. Their ideas were sought by Greek tyrants and Roman emperors. They advised Persian sultans and also chiefs in the Pueblo, Hopi, and Sioux nations. They played an important role at the courts of the Chinese emperors and were prominently employed by European royalty in the Middle Ages and Renaissance. Both men and women can be wise fools. Thinking like one has long been open to all. Historically, however, the majority of those who performed this role at court were males. What did these wise fools do? Put very simply, it was their job to whack the king's thinking out of his habitual thought patterns. The king's advisors were often yes-men and sycophants who told him exactly what he wanted to hear. The king realized that this wasn't a good environment in which to make decisions or conjure up promising alternatives. Therefore, he gave his wise fool a license to parody and ridicule any proposition under discussion so as to shatter the conventional viewpoint. In other words, to be a creative contrarian. The wise fool's candid jokes and observations put the issue in a fresh light and forced the king to re-examine his assumptions. By listening to the wise fool, the king improved his judgment, enhanced his creativity, and protected himself from his groupthink milieu. How do wise fools look at things? Well, they operate in a world that runs counter to conventional patterns. Everyday ways of perceiving, understanding, and acting have little meaning for them. They'll extol the trivial, trifle the exalted, and parody the common perception of a situation. Here are some examples of the wise fool's contrarian approach to life. Wise fools are eager to challenge our usual perceptions. One might say, if a man is sitting on a horse facing the rear, why do we assume that it is the man who is backwards and not the horse? They turn the rules on their head. They look at policies and think of reasons why the reverse objectives could also make sense. Many organizations espouse the value, "We are committed to excellence." They say, "Let's shoot for mediocrity. Imagine the benefits. Less product development time, lower training costs, less quality control, and less production time. If we had mediocre products, we'd have to learn how to sell more aggressively. I'm sure we would be successful because nothing succeeds like mediocrity because everyone understands it so well." Wise fools are irreverent. One might pose a brain teaser such as, what is it that the rich man puts in his pocket that the poor man throws away? When she answers, snot, she forces us to reconsider the wisdom of some of our most basic hygienic practices. They can be absurd. Having lost his donkey, a wise fool knelt down and began exuberantly praising God. A passerby saw him and asked, "Your donkey is missing. Why are you expressing your gratitude to the Almighty?" He replied, "I'm thanking him for seeing to it that I wasn't aboard him at the time. Otherwise, I would be missing as well." They ask odd questions. If you put a dozen roses in your refrigerator and the next day they started smelling like Roquefort cheese, does the cheese smell like roses? They are paradoxical. When I came home, I expected a surprise, but there was no surprise for me. So, of course, I was surprised. Wittgenstein. All of the true things I'm about to tell you are shameless lies. Vonnegut. Only the ephemeral is of lasting value. Ionesco. Wise fools observe the things most people overlook. Why do people who pour cream into their coffee do so after the coffee is already in the cup, rather than pouring it in first and saving themselves the trouble of stirring? They can be cryptic. One might say that the best way to see something is with your ears. This may seem odd, but after you've thought about it, you might agree that listening to a well-written story or poem can stimulate your imagination more than watching TV or a video. Many wise fools see life as a series of metaphors. If one took an intelligence test with this question on it, which is true, A, birds eat seeds, or B, seeds eat birds, she would answer both A and B because she's seen dead birds decomposing on the ground feeding freshly fallen seeds. Wise fools can provoke us into thinking, perceiving, and acting differently. Their offbeat comments can force us to focus on information that we had previously thought was irrelevant. Their playful barbs might inspire us to conjure up an offbeat hypothesis, or perhaps jettison an obsolete assumption. Their candid statements of the obvious might force us to toss aside some of our arrogance. Their sobering directness might help us honestly assess the obstacles we could expect to encounter when implementing a new idea. In other words, the wise fool is the character who jars us into an awareness that there are other ways to look at what we're doing and that we should be seeking better answers than the ones we currently have. The great Danish physicist Niels Bohr felt that being a creative contrarian was a great way to come up with breakthrough ideas. During a tense brainstorming session, he told a colleague, "We all know your idea is crazy. The question is whether it is crazy enough." Some people, however, regard the wise fool as a simpleton, a dunce whose elevator doesn't go all the way to the top, the imbecile whose belt doesn't go through all the loops, the idiot whose bell has no clapper, or the moron who's a few French fries short of a Happy Meal. Nothing could be further from the truth. It takes intelligence, imagination, cleverness, and insight to play the role of the wise fool. A good wise fool needs to be part actor and part poet, part philosopher and part psychologist. Because of their ability to open up people's thinking, wise fools in some cultures have been held in as much esteem as the priest, the medicine man, and the shaman. The great benefit of the wise fool's antics and observations is that they stimulate our thinking. They jolt us in the same way that a splash of cold water awakens us when we're drowsy. We may not like their ideas. Some of them may irritate us and strike us as silly or useless. But they force us to entertain, perhaps only momentarily, alternative ways of looking at our situation. 2. Put on your wise fool's cap. So far, we have established that it's good to have a wise fool to consult with from time to time when we need a creative spark. But what do you do if there isn't one handy to help you put things into perspective? The answer is simple. Be your own wise fool. You're smart, right? Got a sense of humor? Capable of looking at things in a variety of ways? Then put on your wise fool's cap and dig into your bag of tricks. It will open your mind and clear your judgment. For example, try some of the following. Laugh at the problem, perhaps ridiculing your basic assumptions. Point out the hypocrisy in a current situation. See the benefits of looking at it backwards. Doubt the things that others take for granted. Highlight the ambiguity in the problem. Remember those occasions when you thought like a wise fool? Were you more creative? Did you generate a lot of different ideas? Were you bolder and less risk-averse? Were things more enjoyable? I bet the answer to most, if not all, of these questions is yes. From my own 35-year experience conducting creativity workshops, I've found the best sessions I led were those where the participants allowed themselves to be their own wise fools. A good analogy for wise fool thinking is to compare your mind to the transmission of a car. Most of the gears, first, second, drive, etc., are designed to go forward and to get you where you want to go. But sometimes, when you're stuck and can't make forward progress, you need to put the car in reverse so that you can back up and then go forward anew. Obviously, you wouldn't want to drive in reverse most of the time, but it is an important gear to have in the appropriate circumstances. Similarly, most of our thinking habits and strategies are employed to move ahead and to get things done. But sometimes, when you're stuck on a problem, you need to be able to back out of the current situation and then go forward in a different direction. This is what the wise fool is all about. Thinking like one is your mind's reverse gear, and like the car's reverse gear, you probably don't need to adopt a wise fool mindset more than about 5% of the time. Thinking like a wise fool may not give you the right answer or solve your problem, but it will get you out of the rut you're in and put your thinking on a different mental path where you might find some better solutions. Playing the wise fool is not only a lot of fun, it is also a good way to examine your most basic assumptions. Sometimes you'll discard a belief after the wise fool's scrutiny. But it can also happen that if the assumption can withstand a wise fool's probing, you'll have a much better appreciation for why you held that belief in the first place. 3. The wise fool's strategies. How easy is it to be your own wise fool? For some of us, the answer is simple. It's as natural as breathing. I just flip a switch, and I'm there bucking the crowd. Many of us, though, have a bit more difficulty achieving this frame of mind. Since thinking like a wise fool and being a creative contrarian run counter to the conventional ways we have learned how to do things, we may need some assistance to think in this manner. Allow me to introduce the wise fool strategies, These are ideas that will provide you with your wise fool know-how. For years, I've been curious about how wise fools perceive reality and operate in the world. I've especially wanted to discover the basic elements of their behavior so that anyone wishing to emulate them could do so. To this end, I've explored my own thinking tendencies and also shared ideas with other people who have ability to tap into their own inner wise fools. In addition, I've studied the works of many scientists, artists, and writers looking for clues into what they had noticed in their own creative processes, especially when they had gotten a fresh perspective by engaging in wise fool behaviors. I've found that when people are thinking like creative contrarians, they use humor as a fun way to generate ideas, seek out alternative right answers, are reluctant to conform to the majority viewpoint, believe play is a mental lubricant, experiment with making up their own rules, like to mock pet ideas, possess the courage to stick their necks out. Based on my study, I have selected 20 strategies that wise fools employ when they work through a problem, deliberate on a decision, or just want to do things differently. They are listed shortly. You'll notice that each one sounds like a remark a wise fool might share with you if you asked one for their counsel. When you listen to the strategies from first to last, you'll notice that they offer three different types of advice: contrary, creative, and cautionary. Contrary. The early ones deal with how wise fools break out of groupthink situations and express what's on their minds. Creative. The middle ones provide a mix of problem-solving heuristics and creativity tips. And cautionary. The later ones reflect their warnings in an unpredictable world. Together, these 20 strategies form a compendium of wise fool thinking. To develop your ability to think like a creative contrarian, I highly recommend consulting them. Not only will these strategies provoke different and original thoughts each time you turn to them, they will also become trusted companions whose guidance you will welcome. 1. Buck the crowd. 2. Flex your risk muscle. 3. Laugh at it. 4. Seek other right answers. 5. Keep playing with it. 6. Reverse your perspective. 7. Fool around with the constraints. 8. Build on an odd idea. 9. Look for ambiguity. 10. See the obvious. 11. Use your forgettery. 12. Drop what's obsolete. 13. Kiss a favorite idea goodbye. 14. Revisit a discarded idea. 15. Find what's out of whack. 16. Stop fooling yourself. 17. Exercise humility. 18. Imagine the unintended. 19. Develop a thick skin. 20. Shed an illusion. 4. Reap the wise.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.